ladies. Hi, girls. I'm Pastor Melinda, and I want to welcome you to our Inspire Summer Night. We've been waiting for weeks, really months, to be able to come together. And so wherever you are joining us from tonight, welcome to this time. We're uniting heart and soul. We may be across country borders. We may be across continents, but we are coming together as the Inspire Global Sisterhood, and we are inviting all of our friends to join us. Tonight's gonna be special. Whether you're by yourself, maybe you just purchased a ticket, maybe you're in a group at your church, or maybe you're at someone's home because they're hosting this night as a house party. Wherever you are, we want you to know right now, before we even start, that you matter. You matter to us and you matter to God. Your life is valuable. And tonight, as we go through these next hour and a half together, we want you to hear that message over and over. We're going to be encouraged, we're going to be inspired, and we're going to do it together. So bless you, ladies. Enjoy the summer night.
Before you're born, he knew you. It was then that he set you apart. No matter what it is you go through, our God is never that far. Even even if you feel like you're falling hard. His love is a second chance. He knows everything inside your heart. Our God knows who you are. Ay, say that name, Jesus. Say that name, Jesus. Say that name, Jesus. Say that name, Jesus. He calls you one of a kind. You're precious in his eyes. He thought you up inside his mind and he died to give you life. Hey. I think you, thoughts of peace and not evil. Got that future and that hope. He's the one, oh don't you know.
Oh don't you know,
Jesus.
Oh don't you know,
Jesus. You a chosen generation, royal priesthood, holy nation. Call his name, yo, that's salvation. Take that word to every nation. We gotta give the one that saves, the one we love, the one we praise. Take that courage and afraid. He is with you, say that name.
Make sure both your cheeses are shredded. We're gonna shred the Parmesan cheese. Then add both cheeses into the bowl.
Next, you will need to grab your egg and crack it. And then you will need to beat it. And once it's nice and even, you will need to pour it into the bowl of cheese. Add 1 teaspoon of garlic.
Let's add a pinch of oregano. And just a little bit of salt.
Then, you will grab your spatula and mix it. Now you're going to bring out your pan and add the non-sticking spray. Make sure it's all around. And add your mixture into the pan and make sure it's nice and flat out. Now we are going to add salami. You can add your favorite topping if you want to.
Put the pan into the oven at 350 degrees for about 15 minutes.
Girls, remember, you should always have a parent by your side, just in case you make a mistake or don't know what to do.
It's the final countdown!
Trying out different ingredients. I hope you can share this with your friends and family and share the word of God.
Hi, Inspire Sisterhood. We want to give you guys a warm welcome. Also, special thanks to Lily and Rachel who just showed us an awesome recipe.
We'd also like to welcome all of the countries that are joining us today. That is like America, Mexico, Fiji, the Philippines, Austria,
and all the other countries around the world. We want to welcome young and old, all women.
We'd also like to capture this amazing moment by taking out our phones, gathering together, whether you're a party of 1, 2, 10, or even 20, and just taking that selfie.
Awesome. So once you've taken your pictures, you can go ahead and post them and share them on social media. What hashtag can they use, Kasha?
Hashtag Inspire House Party.
Or you can tag us at Inspire Global Sisterhood.
With that said, we are so honored to welcome the special guest speaker, Pastor Gladys Rodriguez.
I am so excited to be with you tonight. I was looking forward to share with you what the Lord placed in my heart. And I want to thank Pastor Melinda Henderson for her kind invitation. Here goes a hug and a kiss for you. I am Pastor Gladys Rodriguez, and I am connecting with you from Springfield, Missouri, USA. I was born in Paraguay, South America, and I was raised in Argentina. So to all my Latina friends out there, os envío un cariñoso saludo y un fuerte abrazo. Y que el Señor les bendiga mucho. So like I said, I was raised in Argentina. My mother was a single mom, a mother of three little girls. I was the youngest. She moved to Argentina looking for a better way of life. My father left her when she was expecting me because she decided that she was gonna have me. She already had two little girls, so my father did not want another one and suggested her to get an abortion. My mother said no, she refused, and because of that, my father left us. So she was left alone, 24 years old, a young mother, single now, raising three little girls. She moved to Argentina for a better way of life, looking for better jobs. And she did have multiple jobs to be able to support us. She worked really, really hard to give us a good education and to provide for us. She had no friends, a non-existent social life. But one thing that always caught my attention is that she lived in constant fear. She was afraid of everything. Well, then again, we were in the 70s. So drugs, violence, gangs were the trio that dominated the streets at that time. And because of that fear, many times this will take her to do some strange things. Like for instance, she was so afraid that something wrong would happen to us. She was so afraid that she will lose her job and she will not be able to provide for us. She was afraid of getting sick. She was afraid that we will get sick. So one time I saw her doing something really strange. She came to the house with rosemary plant, like this one. Smells delicious. But you know what she did? She put it on a plate, she took the leaves and put it on a plate and started burning the rosemary and walking around the house with that plant, and the smoke was coming out and the scent was really strong. And she was going to every corner of our house. We lived in a one-room apartment, only one room, the four of us. So she walked to every single corner with this smoke of rosemary, murmuring a strange prayer that she learned, repeating a prayer actually, for protection for us. Because somebody told her that burnt offering was going to protect us from evil spirits. Strange things. And that's what fear does. It takes us sometimes to do things that we don't understand, some strange things. You know, not too long ago, I actually read the story of a man in the Bible that was doing something kind of similar. And I'll tell you, it's in Job chapter 1, verse 5. We find this man called Job. He was a very wealthy man, actually. He was wealthy. He had 7 sons and he had 3 beautiful daughters. And the sons will have parties every day, each one in their own house, and they will invite the 3 sisters to come and feast with them. So Job will get up at the end of all these festivities. He will get up and burn a sacrifice for each one of his sons and daughters. So think about it, do the math. He had 10 kids. So he will be burning these offerings every morning 10 times. You know how much time that took for him to do that? I cannot even imagine. Start your day like that, burning 10 cows or 10 bulls every day. And you know why he did this? Because he was afraid that his sons and daughters will sin during their festivities. He said, well, maybe they were drunk and they cursed God and they didn't realize it. So he will get up in the morning and offer this to God to appease God, so God won't punish his kids. Fear. Then we find in Job chapter 3, verse 25, that actually Job walked with fear. He knew God. He was actually a man. He was righteous. He was fearful of God. He knew God as a creator. He knew God as a judge. But he did not know God as a loving father. And that was his problem. Love, the lack of love in his life. He thought God was going to punish him or his kids for every little thing that they may or may not, you know, do. So that's exactly what my mother did. Out of fear, she would go and do these strange things. Like, we would be not allowed to have friends come into our house because she was afraid it would be a bad influence for our lives. We were not allowed to go out to play on the streets because the streets were too dangerous. We were not allowed to do many things. So fear paralyzed us. She lived in this constant fear, paralyzed and afraid and doing strange things like burning the rosemary. Why? Why did she do that? Because she did not know God as a loving father. But you know what? Right now we're living in this world that is so imperfect. We're living in the middle of this global pandemic. And I can only imagine the fears that you're going through right now. I actually did. Maybe all of us had a little bit of fear with this or with that. Are my kids going to be okay? I have 2 kids. One is going to the university and they were using masks. And I was afraid that probably he will get sick, you know, and come back with COVID in our house. I don't know what the fears that you are facing right now. Maybe fear that your loved ones will get sick. Maybe fear of that you're losing your job and you're never going to get it back. Or maybe that things are not going to be normal again like they used to be. I don't know what the fears that you're facing in your life. But one thing I want to tell you, we have the antidote for fear. Yes, sweet girl, sweet lady, we have it. And I want to share that with you. This tonight, I want you to open, if you have your Bible, on 1 John chapter 4, verse 18 and 19. 1 John chapter 4, 18 and 19. And I'm going to read from the Amplified Bible. The Amplified Bible says like this, there is no fear in love. Isn't this amazing? Dread does not exist, but perfect love drives out fear. What is perfect love? A love that is complete, a love that is full grown. That's the kind of love that God has for us. It says perfect love drives out fear because fear involves the expectation of divine punishment. That's what Job was doing. Job was afraid that his kids were going to be punished because they did something wrong, and he was burning these sacrifices every single day for each one of them because he was afraid that God will punish his kids. So he says, then 1 John chapter 4, 18. So the one who is afraid of God's judgment is not perfected in love. has not grown into a sufficient understanding of God's love. We love because He first loved us. The antidote for fear is love. A love like no other. A love like no other, the love of God for us. We need to understand, to cast out fear, we need to understand how God loves us. And I want to share with you today, number one, God loves us with everlasting love. Jeremiah 31:3 says that He loved us with everlasting love. What's everlasting? A love that lasts forever, that never ends. No matter what you did, no matter where you came from, God loves you. He loves you so much that, watch what He says in John 3:16. He says that He loves you so much that He doesn't want you to die. He wants to spend eternity with you. It says there that for God so loved the world that He, the Lord, and He loved you, that He gave His one and only Son. And this is why. So no one need be destroyed, but believing in Him, anyone can have a whole and lasting life. He loves you so much, first of all, with everlasting love, He says, right? Everlasting, never ends, no matter what you do, no matter where you came from, your background, your last name, your language, your culture, God still loves you. And He loves you with a love that wants to spend time with you forever. John 3:16, He doesn't want you to die. He wants to spend time with you forever if you believe in Him as your Savior. And then His love is also so great that He will never reject you. Some of us may be dealing with rejection right now. Don't you have this awful feeling when you go to apply for a job and there's other people over there and then it's your turn and you don't get picked? You know, it reminds me when I was a little girl. I was rejected since the moment I was born, even before I was born, by my father. And then growing up, I was rejected in playgroups because I wasn't pretty enough. I was rejected when I was a teenager because I didn't have the nicest clothes or my clothes weren't trendy. Growing up as a young woman, I was rejected because I came from another country, I had another culture. So I know a lot about rejection. But you know what? God says that He will never reject us. The Lord tells us in His word that when we come to Him, John 6:37, Jesus said, "Whoever comes to Me, I will never drive away." And another version says, "I will never let go." He's never gonna let you go. The antidote for fear and rejection is believing in God's love, a love like no other. When you believe that God loves you, there's not going to be room there for you to be afraid of getting sick. You know why? Because He says He's your healer. When you believe that God loves you, you are not going to be afraid when you lose your job because the Bible says He is your provider. When you believe that God loves you, fear, anxiety, stress, and depression are not going to be a threat to you because the Lord says that He is going to be with you always and He's never going to let you go. He's going to be with you always. So to cast out fear, we need to understand that God loves you. God loves you so much with everlasting love, with eternal love, a love that's never going to end, a love that will never reject you, a love that wants to spend time with you. The only thing you got to do, not like my mom or Joe burning offerings so I can please God. Oh, I have to do something to please Him. I remember my mom spending hours just repeating prayers and prayers and prayers trying to please God. She thought that that way she was going to please the Lord because she had no knowledge that God loved her. So she would do sacrifices like walk for hours to a certain place to say a prayer on her knees in that certain place to please God, not knowing not knowing that all you have to do is just believe in the Lord in your heart. Confess your sins, repent for the things that you're doing that displease the Lord, and receive Him as your Savior. That's all you have to do. And the doors are open and His arms are open for you to receive this love and enjoy this love, the love that is no other. Because only when you understand how much God loves you, you are going to begin to love yourself. You cannot love yourself, let alone others, if you don't understand how much God loves you. You know, because I suffered from rejection for so long, I hated myself. I thought there was something wrong with me. I thought that it wasn't pretty enough. I didn't have the right color of the hair. My eyes were not right. My height, I was too short. I was too skinny. There was always something wrong with me. I look at the mirror and I will say literally to myself, I hate you. Because I didn't understand how much God loved me. So when I was 16 years old, somebody took me to a ladies' prayer meeting, a beautiful group in a home like right now you are. And I want to thank you so much. If you invited somebody to come tonight, thank you so much. You were guided by the Holy Spirit. You were guided by God to bring somebody. And do it. Keep doing that. Because somebody invited me to go to, and it was also summer. How you like that? It was during the summer. I was 16. And somebody said, you want to come to this house? We're going to be talking to God. And I thought, talking to God? Can you really talk to God? Because I did not know God as my loving Father. I know Him as a creator, just like Job. And I know Him as a judge, but not as a loving Father. So I was excited. I didn't know what this love of a father was. I never had it. I never experienced that. So I went to this prayer meeting. The ladies were so sweet. There was some amazing things to eat and drink. And we had some fellowship and all of this. And then the prayer time came. And when these women started to pray, something happened in my heart. I felt something I never felt before. I felt this beautiful presence of God. And I asked somebody that was next to me, what is this that I'm feeling? And she says, that's the presence of God. Would you like to receive Jesus as your Savior and experience God's love, the love of a father? And I say, yes. That's what I was looking for all my life. The love of a father. I need that. I want that. And that day, my life changed forever. I experienced what it meant to be loved. I experienced what it meant to be accepted the way I was. When I left that house in that summer night, I was a complete different person. I was able to experience the love of God. And fear, that fear that I grew up with of going out, having friends, or enjoying life, was just cast away from me. It went away from my life forever. And then life and tragedies and sickness and things come upon you. And we constantly need to be refreshing that love in our lives. Constantly we need to be remembering, reading the scripture, and remember God still loves me. I am not perfect. I'm never going to be perfect until I see Him in the way He is. But God still loves me. All I have to do is to come, repent before Him, and receive this love. And start loving myself as I see myself the way God sees me. And the only way I'm going to do that is when I read the Bible, when I read the scriptures, when I start to believe the way God sees me. And how? How is it that God sees me? God sees me beautiful. God sees me as a princess. God sees me as His daughter. Jesus died for me. God's only Son was sent here to pay a price for my sins. That's how much God loves me. So I have value. You have value. You are beautiful. You are precious. So much so that your life cost the blood of Jesus. So the only way you can start loving yourself is when you trust and believe that God loves you too. And then you can also start loving others. Sometimes we think so much about, during this pandemic and the lockdown, we were locked down here too in Springfield, Missouri. And there were days and days and days that we didn't know what to do. Some of us lost weight, others picked up a lot, right? And we were cleaning the closets and cleaning the house and doing this and doing that and thinking about ourselves and what are we gonna do and we're gonna go. Here there was a frenzy of toilet paper. Everybody was going to the streets and buying toilet paper. It was like the end of the world if you didn't have. People were literally fighting in the supermarkets to get toilet paper. Can you believe that? So here I found myself going to get this. I'm like, wait a minute. Stop, Gladys, stop. Think about this. Because we were thinking just about ourselves, what I need. God forbid I don't have toilet paper in my house, so I gotta go get them. People were stealing toilet paper from other people's shopping carts. Can you believe that? I saw this. It was incredible because we were just thinking about our own selves, what I need, okay? So one thing that really helped us in my household to have an equilibrium, have a balance during this lockdown was to start thinking about others. How can I help others? So our church was giving food away, and I said to my kids, let's take both of our cars and let's go to the church and let's pack up the car with food and let's start giving that away to other people. People that are in need. Let's start calling people. Not me just waiting for me. Nobody calls me. And sometimes we sit down there, oh, well, the leaders don't call me. Poor me. My friends forgot about me. And we start feeling sorry about ourselves. But we need to do. It's just, okay, they don't call me. I'm going to call them. How do you like that? You pick up the phone. You start calling people. See how they are. Offer a simple prayer. And that will change your day. So you reach out to other people and try to meet some of their needs with prayer, with some food, with friendship, with whatever you can do at the moment. It doesn't have to be big. Just do something to love others. So tonight, I want to inspire you to start trusting and believing that God loves you with everlasting love. To start loving yourself as you see yourself the way God sees you, and to start loving others, doing small things. Sometimes we think that to show our love and appreciation for others, we got to do big things. No, you don't have to. A phone call can save someone's life. Do you know how many times the Lord prompted in my heart to call somebody? And when I would call that somebody, I would say, listen, I felt in my heart to call you. I don't know why, but can I just pray with you? And sometimes this person would say, oh my gosh, you don't know how I needed somebody to call me today. So maybe a phone call is all that you need to do. Maybe you need to do a little more. Maybe you need to invest in somebody with a little love offering. Whatever the Lord places in your heart, just do it. Don't delay it and do it. So my sweet, beautiful lady, I want to inspire you tonight. First of all, if you're going through sickness, if you're going to the loss of a job or the loss of a loved one, some of us have friends and families living far away from us in another country, and you're worried and you're concerned. I'm just going to tell you that fear will do that to you, will worry you, will concern you, will take the joy away from you, will take the peace away from you. And tonight I want to say to you, give it to the Lord. I want to pray for you right now for those that are going through sickness, for those that lost their jobs, because God is your healer and God is your provider. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, I thank you so much because we can come to you, because your word says that you never reject us. You're right there waiting for us to come with our petition. And tonight we want to pray for all those people that are sick or lost a loved one or a friend. I pray that you will encourage their hearts. I pray that your peace that surpasses all understanding will come and take control and take away that fear from their lives. I pray that you will touch those sick bodies right now and that you will raise them up so they can feel whole again and complete again. In Jesus' name, your word says that you are their healer. So I proclaim that healing tonight for those sick bodies. In the name of Jesus, rise up and be healed. Thank you, Lord. But maybe you're saying to me, well, Pastor Gladys, I really don't understand what you're talking about because I don't know God as my Savior. I heard of him as a creator, that he created the universe, but I don't know him as my Savior. So tonight I want to invite you to really open your heart and receive Jesus as your loving Savior. Is your the first time that you're coming to one of these meetings? I want to pray for you. I want to pray with you. I want that privilege to guide you to the loving arms of Jesus. So all you have to do is trust him, believe in him, open your heart, repent for your sins, and receive him as your Savior. So if you're willing to do that, to start experiencing that love that casts out fear, that puts anxiety away and depression out of your life, I invite you right now to close your eyes. I know some of you are going through hard times right now. I know, I can feel it in my heart that some of you are going through depression and you're embarrassed to share with anybody because you think that nobody should know how you're feeling. Some of you just starting recently to experience anxiety and you don't know what to do. I want to pray tonight with you. Open your eyes, open your heart better and close your eyes and let's pray. Dear Jesus, first of all, I want to pray for all these ladies that want to receive you as your Savior right now. I pray that you will forgive them of their sins. And I pray that you will come and dwell in their hearts. Thank you, Jesus, for bringing them tonight. And I also want to pray for those that are experiencing anxiety, depression, fear, and loneliness. I pray that you will come upon their lives, bless them, and that they have peace tonight. That they can walk away with peace tonight, knowing that you are with them and you will never leave them or forsake them. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord. Thank you so much. So, my sweet lady, before I go, I have one more scripture I want to share with you. And it says like this from the prophet Isaiah. Isaiah 41:10 from the NIV version says, "So, do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." So, precious lady, Jesus is with you. He is telling you from the word that he is with you, that he is going to hold your hand, that he is going to go before you, that he is going to give you strength. He is with you. So I want to leave you with this word. This is a beautiful word where the Lord is encouraging not to be afraid, not to live with fear. There's nothing you can do to please him anymore, but just believe in him and obey him. He already loves you with everlasting love. So walk away tonight with that joy, with that peace of knowing that you can rest and enjoy your life. What did you say? Enjoy? In the midst of this pandemic? Are you crazy? How can I enjoy? You can enjoy life because you have the antidote for fear. And the antidote is the love of God in your life. A life that will never perish. A life that is full with the love of God. So enjoy your life. The small things, your family, your friends, the provision that God has for you. Start reaching out to other people and show the love that is in your heart. So I want to send you a kiss and a virtual hug. And I hope that you were inspired tonight with the love of the Lord. And remember, he loves you with everlasting love.
Just the other day, she smiled and she said, "Well, I'm doing okay, but I felt a pain." I took her hand in mine, said, "It's gonna work out fine." But as she turned, I wondered, did I just bend her a line? What she needed most was a word of hope, a prayer or two, a little more time and a timely word could have pulled her through. So I think of her and I wonder too, is anybody hurting? And so sitting right next to you. Shine the light, share your faith, show the world that Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the way. Together we can make a difference. Be a beacon in the dark of night. Share your faith, hold it high, shine the light. Anywhere you go, any country road or city street, any lonely life, a hurting heart, somebody in need, they all ask one thing: where is love and truth? But if you know Jesus, then you know what to do. Shine the light, share your faith, show the world that Jesus is the answer, that Jesus is the way. Together we can make a difference. Be a beacon in the dark of night. Share your faith, hold it high, shine the light. Let your light so shine, so everybody will see Jesus. Let your light so shine to glorify your Father.
Eclipsed by glory. redemption and hears our cries. Drawn to redemption in the grace of his eyes. If grace is an ocean, we're all sinking. And heaven meets earth like a sloppy wet kiss, and my heart turns violently inside of my chest. I don't have time to maintain.
Territory, fighting unseen enemies like never before.